The latter. I got a taste of love that stained my tongue. It made me feel so brave, expressive, and young. But no one told me how hard it would be to remove the stain of the one who once loved me. This bittersweet taste of love is too familiar. Like eating new food that's no longer peculiar. How am I to feel trapped in this endless duality? Lonely, happy with a sprinkle of sexuality. There's so many questions I ask, but no reply. Howling at the moon, crying at the night sky. Is this what it means to find oneself? To have all your favorite books thrown off the shelf? Is this what it's like to truly feel alone? No one to hold, call your own, stop the aching of your soul. Love is not determined by the quantity, but the quality. So why do we treat it with sincere impartiality? As if one heart isn't as strong as three. As if an empire didn't need one king to help them see. What if the world was coming to an end? Would you have died with words left unsaid? Would you be satisfied, proud of the person you've become? Or would you want to change and alter the outcome? How do you achieve your dreams without going insane? How do I find all the answers to the questions that remain? Is it bad that I want to run? Run until my lungs go numb. Until I look back to see my past, my life, has already caught up to me. So what is the point of love and pain? Avoid the latter until the former remains. There were only one set of footprints in the sand. Now there are two. I smile, holding his hand. And there it is. My life has now become the latter.